photographs and a new federal report just released on that Firestone house explosion back in 2017 that left two people dead and one woman badly burned. The National Transportation Safety Board, which regulates pipelines, released 68 different documents today as part of its 2.5-year-long investigation, and the problem solvers are on it. Investigative reporter Lori Jane Gliha has been pouring through the records and has more on what the NTSB has to say. Lori Jane?
Yeah, they released these transcripts and investigative files, and they blamed government furloughs and other larger accidents as the reason this investigation took so long. But the report says the probable cause of the explosion and the fire was due to a leak in an improperly abandoned pipeline that was most likely severed during the construction of the house. This explosion obliterated the home in April of 2017, killing Joey Irwin and his brother-in-law Mark Martinez. They were installing a water heater at the time. Aaron Martinez was also home and badly burned. There are no records showing when the line was cut, but NTSB investigators found the only known construction at the residence was in 2015 when the house was built. They found three severed lines about 6 feet from the foundation of the house that were all initially connected to natural gas wells. The federal investigation also found the lines were not properly abandoned and that local authorities also contributed to the accident for allowing homes to be built next to the oil and gas production fields without having complete documentation from the operator about the location of all the pipelines it owns. Now, I talked to the Colorado Oil and Gas Conservation Commission, which regulates oil and gas development here in the state, and they said oil and gas companies have until October 31st to deliver a map of their flow lines to the state, and that the intention is to make those maps public sometime soon. Meanwhile, the state has published draft rules that would add precautions and safety measures when it comes to flow lines, and those are supposed to be finalized sometime in November. The commission also says it is proceeding with enforcement action against the oil and gas company, and that company told us it respects and appreciates the NTSB report. I'm Lori Jane Gliha, Fox 31.